Good morning, friends. Today we are here to understand about the Azure Active Directory, and I will show you how you can create a Azure Active Directory. So Azure Active Directory basically is a very important component in Azure, wherein you can actually control your everything, basically the all resources on which are you are creating it on Azure, as well as different type of applications can be created. And then on top of it, it can be linked to the integrations. Okay, so hope you can see my screen, and let me go to the Azure Active Directory. And once we go to Azure Active Directory, we will see a tenant. You can see my tenant is already registered, but I will show you how we can create a new tenant. Click on Manage Tenant, and once you get the tenant, you just click on Create. And once you click on create a tenant, you will see two options. Basically, one is about Azure Active Directory, and second is about the Azure Active Directory B2C tenant. So B2C tenant is something which is created once it is actually related for the business, wherein we create for our business, and then it is basically for the customers as well. Basically, business to customer. Okay, so right now over here, we know that Azure B2C will always have some limitations. So that's the reason we will go for the Azure Active Directory, and we can create the Azure Active Directory now. So we will say next. I will choose the organization name as Google, maybe Noida. And over here, let me choose as Google. GBN is basically the Gautam Buddha Nagar, and the data center I will make it as United States and click next. I think the validation got passed, and I will say create. So while creating, it will ask you about whether you are a robot or not, and fill in challenge, the captcha code. KW and then submit, and behind that it is actually provisioning a tenant named googlegbn.onmicrosoft.com, and it will get it created. It takes some time and it will be created. In the meantime, where it is getting processed, we will try to create a duplicate tab and see if it has been created or not. We will switch back to the portal.azure.com and then look for the home. Go for the home and see type Azure Active Directory. You will find it on the top. Quickly see if that has been created or not. Yes, it has been now created, and this same can be available over here. While you can filter it. This is the new filter which is available on portal.azure.com. So you will get it. Yeah, so it will give you the complete list of tenants here. Yeah, this is the list of tenants. Again, you can switch it. You can see we have the default and we have the directories as well. We have the two directories over here. And based on our favoritism, we can actually go ahead and make it as favorite. We just click those stars, and it is actually creating this as a favorite. This is my default. That's the reason whenever you see the overview, you see one of the current or a default directories. This is directly you can switch it to Google Noida. And if you want to see the all directories, you can. This is the button wherein you can actually see the all directories. Same way, once we have created the directory, we will further in my next video blog, you will see how we can go ahead and create a attach a subscription. Okay, so in portal.azure.com, we have two important things. First one is creation of your Azure Active Directory, and second one is your subscription. So subscription creation, I will show how we can do it, and I will also try to create a resource group and show it in the next blog, video blog. Thank you, and you have a good evening, good morning, and your rest of the day. Thank you.